I'm George Nonaka from RIKEN Center for Computational Science, or RCCS, and this poster presents some preliminary results from the investigation on the impact of the cooling water temperature on the Oak Forest Park system and its facility. This is a collaborative work done with Fumiyoshi Shoji, also from RIKEN RCCS, and Professor Toshihiro Hanawa from the University of Tokyo, and also Joint Center for Advanced HPC, or JCA-HPC. The benefits of the hot water cooling for improving the HPC and data centers' energy efficiency is widely known. However, for a fairly evaluation of its effectiveness, there is a need to take into consideration not only the benefits, but also the possible side effects due to increase in the operational temperature, and such as those shown here, performance degradation and node power consumption. In this work, we focused on a systematic and quantitative evaluation on the impact of the cooling water temperature on the HPC system and its facility. As a case study, we investigated the Oak Forest Park system, which is an Intel Knight Landing-based supercomputer and uses water cooling for the compute node racks and air cooling for the storage and other parts. The regular cooling water temperature is set to around 12 degrees Celsius, and for this investigation, we also used lower 9 degrees Celsius and higher 18 degrees Celsius temperature. We also used a set of applications from the Intel MKL benchmark suite and a parallel finite element method application named GeoFEM. And this graph shows the power consumption of the water cooling system when using different temperature settings. And the highlighted regions in green color represent the 3-hour period utilized for the analysis and comparison. And here is the power consumption, including the air cooling part. This graph shows the power consumption of the compute nodes, that is, Knight Landing CPUs, during the running of different sets of applications with different sizes, mainly power of 2 number of processes from 128 to 4096. And here is the power consumption of the compute node racks, as well as the storage and other parts. These bar plots show the estimated energy consumption for the 3-hour period for each of the temperature settings. And the red portions in the left side graph shows the energy consumption of the compute node racks, which is water cooled. And we used PUE, power usage effectiveness, and COP, coefficient of performance, as the metric for the evaluation. PUE is a well-known metric for evaluating the energy efficiency of HPC and data centers, and low PUE value represents better energy efficiency. And COP is used to evaluate the energy efficiency of the cooling system, and high COP value means high efficiency. From these graphs, we can clearly observe that the values become better as the temperature increases. And this work presented some preliminary results of the investigation on the impact of the cooling water temperature on the Oak Forest Park system and its facility. We could confirm that better PUE and COP values can be obtained by using higher temperature settings. However, we could also perceive some personal degradation on the HPC system nodes, and a more detailed analysis is still ongoing and remains as a future work. At the end, we would like to acknowledge all these people and institutions, and we will be happy to receive any questions or comments. Thank you very much.